Hey Internet, how does feeling relate to emotions? We talk about feeling as tracking values, but then we also talk about emotions. So like what's going on there? Is it tracking emotions or is it tracking values? It's really doing both. Emotions and our responses to things are kind of hints at things that we value. So when someone has an emotional response to something, that leads us to where those values are. So when someone goes like, ooh, ooh, in response to something, that they're having a positive emotional reaction. And when they're going, they're having a negative emotional reaction. And these things are obvious, right? For most of us, I would hope. Obviously, there's some more subtle things and there's more gray areas. So these are like the ends of the spectrum, right? There's more gray area in the middle in terms of like, oh, I'm kind of like okay with this, but I'm not like excited about it. What FE is doing, therefore, is tracking all of that, even that gray stuff in the middle and trying to parse it, really trying to understand how people are feeling about things. Feeling, right? What is the vibe that is coming off of this thing? How are people feeling about stuff? That's like their emotions. That's their values that are underneath of those emotions. Because we give off our emotions. We don't just like say our values. We respond emotionally when something excites us, right? And we respond emotionally when something upsets us. This experience, this something, right? Whatever it is impacting us, putting off those values. And there's chemical stuff and what blah, 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 science. I'm not getting into the scientific nuances here. What I am talking about is how emotional output is something that we can track, and it is sort of a signal to what our values are. These are the things that we care about. That is what FE is looking for. So it is trying to put out things that will generate a response. We want to see some emotional response so that we can respond to it. And say like, oh, this person liked that thing, this person didn't. Try something else. And obviously we're making some kind of logical connection underneath to say like, oh, this person didn't like this, this person did. How can I adjust to make it something that both of them will like? So that's like the underlying TI of it. The FE is then looking at those responses as some kind of signal towards what those people are valuing. It's not tracking the emotions per se. It's not saying like, oh, this person feels this way. It is considering how those emotions relate to that person on a deeper level. It doesn't understand what's going on under the deeper level, but it is able to sort of read that outer expression and therefore make some sort of assumption. And it is an assumption, right? And that's where I guess FE can get in trouble with FI users, and they're not seeing complexity that's underneath there. But that can be difficult, right? And that's one of those things where FI is looking inside, comparing its states internally and not feeling the responsibility to express outwardly. As I talked about in my previous video, FE can have more trouble understanding what's going on underneath because they're not telling us directly, right? And in a group setting, that can be really difficult to unpack because I can't go to all those levels deep with all the other people in the room. That's something that kind of needs to have a one-on-one conversation later to really sort of dig into those inner experiences. I think I personally would encourage FI users to reach out to FE users if they are feeling like they're not being understood properly and try and clear up the misunderstanding. That is something that you're going to need to work on with someone if they are misunderstanding you consistently and you're tracking that and seeing that for yourself. I personally find it really helpful to get to know people that I don't know that well so that I can make better assumptions, really, because that's really what it is. It's a surface level assumption about how can I align people in the room, especially like SE, FE. I'm very much in the moment trying to see like what's something that we can align on here. If I don't understand who this person is, and that can be difficult, so I might have to resort to more surface level things, right? Then it's even more not representing what is going on with that person. That's one of those problems that FE users really have to understand how to manage. They need to understand how to get those layers deep with people. In the broader context, it's really difficult. You can't connect with everyone all at once on a deep level. It's just not something that is going to happen. as a wrap up here, Effie isn't trying to manipulate emotions. It's trying to understand what the values are. When you see an Effie user trying to like move emotions, it's not so much to just like force you to move. It's they're trying to understand where you are so they can align on the spectrum. They want to harmonize somewhere, so they need to know where people are so that they can say like, oh, this is something that we share. This is something we have in common. This is, it's seeking connection, right? That's the whole point of DE, just DE in general, seeking connection. So where can we connect? Where can we harmonize on the values? The emotions hint at the values. So we can kind of see like, oh, we're both vibing on this thing. Like positive energy is coming here. Ooh, this is a good area to be in. Or so there's some turmoil here. I can feel it. Maybe we should shift the topic somewhere else. If it's an appropriate time to try and resolve and unpack that, that's where the TI can kind of come in and understand what's going on in those layers deep with people, which that's usually better in a smaller environment, right? As I've keep bringing up. I hope this is helpful in helping understand how Effie isn't so much trying to manipulate and track emotions, but is really just trying to get at what people's values are and where we can align. Like and subscribe for more. Also, check out my website. It's subjectivepersonality.com. Do blog posts at least once a week right now. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later. Bye. Ooh, feeling, right?